Thank you, David. He is comfortable with his decision. Governor Haley Barbour talks about the firestorm and backlash he's facing after issuing a pardon and clemency list with more than 215 names. My co-anchor Stephanie Maxwell is live in the newsroom with his words after practically avoiding the media for most of the week. Stephanie.
Well, Darren, you are right. Until today, we just had just the statement from Governor Barbour, but he decided it was time to talk only to the Mississippi media when he realized that people were thinking 200 inmates got out of prison this week. Well, most of them have already been out on the streets, so only 10 people have been or will be released. He said if he had known that it had been interpreted that way, he would have responded much sooner.
Hey, y'all.
Former Governor Haley Barbour won't stop defending his decision to grant a pardon or clemency to more than 200 inmates this week. He says he's at peace with giving a get-out-of-jail-free card to former trustees, mostly murderers, who work with him at the governor's mansion.
I have absolute confidence, so much confidence, that I've let my grandchildren play with these five men. I've let them ride their tricycles out on the driveway with them watching out for them. I have no question in my mind that these five guys are not a threat to society.
Barbour believes those five trustees are least likely to commit another crime because they were involved in crimes of passion. Friday, one of those freed murderers who killed his wife tried to defend Barbour on national news.
I've been saved. I've been baptized. I've been reading the Bible. With 12 and a half years. So it's just a true blessing. I didn't even do this. God did this. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? God bless Hayden, touch Hayden Barbour heart to do this for us.
I believe in second chances, and I try hard to be forgiving. Christianity teaches us forgiveness.
Barbour says it's been a tradition for governors to pardon the mansion trustees at the end of their terms. But our new governor, Phil Bryant, told us he does not agree with that.
I had an aunt that was kidnapped, raped, and murdered. I'm a former deputy sheriff. I don't think people in the future will have to worry about me pardoning anyone.
Another hot topic, the Scott sisters. Barbour suspended their controversial life sentences last year, but they still don't understand why they did not get a full pardon.
I feel like that it was a personal thing because me and my sister from day one, we have stood on our innocence that we did not do it. We have went by our guidelines on being on parole. And it's just, you know, it's a hurting feeling where we have to, you know, stay on parole for something. It seems like we're paying for the crime all over again.
The Scott sisters never admitted they were guilty. The Scott sisters never said we're sorry. And they never did anything to redeem themselves. Because you can't ask for redemption until you admit that you sinned.
On the other hand, Barbour said he heard that from Karen Irby, who was sentenced for a deadly DUI wreck that killed two doctors. She's now on house arrest. Barbour says he can understand why the families of the victims are seething.
I see it. It's very hard to forgive when somebody does something terrible. I respect that. I not only understand it, I respect it. But the state is not an individual who wants vengeance.
He says he can walk away from this week's firestorm with a clear conscience.
Governor, yes, ma'am. This whole fiasco taints your legacy. No.
Thanks,
how
y'all.
Do you feel if they go back to jail?
Well, Darren, I did ask Barbour about the process that they go through these pardon applications. They actually had a team of four go through all those legal documents. He was able to ask them questions, and then they gave him a recommendation, and then that's how it sort of ended.
So it wasn't like he just signing these things away. There was actually a team looking at
right.
each of these individuals. You know, there's been a lot of chatter about changing the state constitution because of this. To kind of take away some of the pardon powers from governors. What did he have to say about that?
Well, he says it should stay how it is. He says if there is a change, it takes away that opportunity for people to have hope and a reason to try to do better. So he is totally against that, but we're going to see what happens with that throughout the year.
Going to have to wait and see.
Yeah.
All right, good job. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Well, in his news conference today, Barbour said that this uproar is really just politically motivated. He claims the attorney general never scrutinized his Democratic predecessor about his pardon.
I did not anticipate that this would be all about politics. You know, when Ronnie Musgrove, my predecessor, left office, the day he left, he pardoned someone, never published anything in any newspaper in the world. Jim Hood didn't peep. Nobody has ever, as far as I can tell, ever challenged a pardon on some very technical procedural ground.